Hi everyone, welcome to last episode of this course. You made it. You learn all the skills to start creating digital art. We used an iPad for the entire course, but the Mac and iPhone version of our software function very much the same. So you can confidently say that you can now design with vectors. What seemed daunting at the beginning, I bet feels like a walk in the park now. We went through all our tools, gesture and functionalities. Every nook and cranny of our app, to show you just how easy it is to get started. The last lesson today is layout design. We will learn more text functionalities and understand the principles of designing a beautiful layout. So, let's go. First of all, in simple terms, layout design refers to the design of print and digital materials, like newspapers, magazines, posters, websites, and apps. So any design where elements like text, shapes, images, and illustrations are arranged in a way to convey a message the fastest way possible. Today we'll focus on designing a poster for a film screening that we called Roar Out. As with the logo, let's start with a simple brief. It's part of an independent film festival, and the poster should be fun, electric, and colorful. Plus, the poster should clearly show the date, the edition, and some information about the venue and sponsors. For the most part, we'll reuse the techniques that we learned until now. One of my favorites is autotrace, so let's put that to good use. The moment I heard the name Roar Out, my mind immediately went to tigers. So let's use this tiger image I found on Unsplash and resize it so it fits in this lower corner here. If I apply autotrace now, the background will get lost with the stripes. If you think about it, this is actually the reason tigers have stripes. So let's apply a mask. First, we're tracing our tiger with the pencil tool. Let's just go with the fastest route here. Because afterward, we can clean up the outline a bit with the note tool. I especially want to keep these lines sharp here at the edges. So let's move to select our nose and delete them. The rest will do just fine. I know that we can get away with this being less than perfect. Now let's select both the vector pad and the image and heat mask. If you remember from our previous episodes, the mask shape would normally need to be under the object that we're cropping. But the nifty thing about cropping an image and a vector is that vector pad can be anywhere in the layers. And our software will understand automatically what you're trying to do. Alright, now we can use autotrace. I find that sketch mode works well with our sketches too. Play around with these settings until you get it right. And boom. Just make sure the vectors are back in the mask group. And done. Let's create symmetry here by duplicating the tiger and mirroring it horizontally. And this is our starting point. Not bad. Now I want a vibrant background. And if you look at the color palette we've been using this entire course, turquoise is basically asking us to use it. Let's give it some more dimension with a gradient. And I've chosen a pale yellow to complement it. Don't forget to adjust the handles. There's no light source here per se, but I want my gradient to go from up down rather than left right. And here's what I meant before with the mask being transparent. If it has an opacity, then the tigers would get a cutout effect instead. Since we mentioned symmetry before, let's talk in more detail about the principles of layout design. While a fully symmetrical design is not a must, there are a handful of grid types that you can rely on to make your composition look good. And you can read more about them in the article below. Moving on to the focal point, let's address a second principle you should follow. Make sure you have just one focal point in your entire design. We're creating it by adding this big red circle right here in the middle. If this doesn't draw a viewer's attention, I don't know what does. Also, notice how the tigers are actually pointing to it, thus leading the viewer's eyes throughout the layout with ease. Use symbolic arrows and pockets of information to guide your audience to the content that they need to consume. Let's add the name of our event here. Using the typeface called Dry Brush, add 108 points. I like that this aesthetic really matches the auto trace result. With headlines and big points like this one, every millimeter counts. And here's where we can play around with all these characteristics. Like kerning, tracking, and line height. Kerning adjusts the spacing between two consecutive letters. V and A is the most common letter combination that requires kerning. You'll be amazed at how this small detail can impact your overall aesthetic. There are other common places to look for kerning, one of which is the letter T, here in our title. A negative value will bring the letters closer together, while a positive value will increase the space in between the letters. You can play around with kerning until you feel like you developed an eye for good spatial awareness. Tracking acts very similarly, but it defines the space between all letters all at once. So you can spread the letters out or bring them closer together. Spreading letters out can help with legibility, but try not to overdo it. So I'm going to leave mine like this. Line height is pretty self-explanatory. Wield this power to make text look better and more legible. These operations are not necessary for all the text in your design. They are mainly used for typographic compositions, logotypes, and headings. Now that the title is done, let's move on to the second most important piece of information on our poster, which is the date. So let's use it to fill out this negative space here in between the tigers. I will change the font for visual interest, and I will make the text smaller, at around 87 points. This technique announces to the viewers the order of importance of my elements. The name of the event is the most important piece of information, while the date is the second. This is what is called visual hierarchy, and it's an important way to convey your message in the most efficient way possible. I've decided to add a line between the month and date, so it's easier to understand. And now we're going to bring the same element in this upper corner. This is another principle of layout design, and it advises us to use repetition in order to make various areas feel connected and part of the same composition. Also here, we're going to add some more information about the event, which is charity series number 9. To keep up with consistency, we're still using Futura, but medium this time around. I'm simply continuing to add text around my design. One, to bring extra calls to action, like save the date. Two, in order to convey more information to our audience, like the location and the sponsors. I'm sticking with Futura from now on, since it's much more legible than Dry Brush. And since we're working with pretty small fonts from here on. You can use this nifty fit bounce to text size option to make your text boxes easier to manipulate. The operation basically does what it says on the label. What's more, you can also outline text. So for example, for the text here in the middle, instead of applying a gradient, I could have outlined my text. And then I could have subtracted from the circle. But I decided I wanted to have more control over my color, so I applied a gradient instead. Last but not least, we're going to add a bit of texture. So I'm going to bring in this image that looks like white noise. And then I will apply a blending mode. I prefer multiply this time around. I'm also going to lower the opacity to make it more subtle. Notice the difference it makes? I feel like it gives a really cool paper effect to the design. And this is the final result. As it is custom, we save the best for last. We learned a ton today, and I hope you had fun in the process. But I also feel like a recap is in order. The million-dollar question is, what is the secret to good design? Well, the principles you learned today can help you achieve it. Use existing formats to get you started. Today we relied on a symmetrical grid, with the two tigers facing each other. Have just one focal point, and respect visual hierarchy in text. Use the elements of your design to guide the viewer's eyes in a way that helps push your message forward. Use negative space in a smart way and don't overclutter. Repetition helps give your design a theme. That's it! Throughout these 9 episodes, we show you all the tools, principles, tips and tricks to design like a pro. Use them wisely. But don't forget to break a rule here and there as well. It will add depth and variety to your designs. Tag us on social media if you recreate any designs I made for this course. We have more courses coming, so stay tuned. See you next time. Bye!